Hey, brothers and sisters, this is your favorite brother from another mother, Brother Patrick. Hope you guys are doing all right. Praise God Almighty, through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all ye creatures here below. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Bless his holy name. Brothers and sisters, hope you guys are all doing all right tonight. You know, I was just, I talked on the phone to Brother Gary. Bear 049, he called me and we prayed on the phone, and you know, the Lord had just give me fresh manna, you know, and the Lord gave me just a awesome piece of fresh manna I wanted to share with you. It's just so awesome to me. To those who of us who are spiritual, this stuff is awesome, you know, and that's a whole nother video where I need to talk about so many people that are thinking in the flesh, not in the spirit. It's very sad. My brothers and sisters, I know most people watching my video, they're into the spiritual stuff because that's my ministry. But anyway, you know, Jesus, in Acts chapter 2, when Peter preached on the day of Pentecost, Peter said that, quoting about King David, when King David spoke in the Psalms about, "You will not allow my flesh to see corruption." And then Peter explained that, you know, King David, of course, his tomb is here, and David is buried right here, and he's with us, and his flesh did see corruption. But the Lord Jesus was who King David was prophesying about, the Messiah. King David was prophesying about the Messiah, whose flesh would not see corruption. "You would not allow my flesh to see corruption." So Jesus, being only in the grave for 3 days, you know, that's what he's referring to in the natural. He was resurrected. Therefore, his body didn't see decay or corruption, as it says in the King James. But the Lord just dropped this awesome fresh manna on me because Gary and I were discussing about people being here during the tribulation and serving God and all of this, and about, you know, some of the church might not be raptured, and people who are truly saved, the wise virgins, the true bride. I made videos about that. I'm talking about the true bride of Christ, those 5 wise virgins. And then the Lord just spoke of that word through me and said that, you know, "Didn't I say in my word, you know, that I would not allow my flesh to see corruption?" God would not allow his body to see corruption. So what the Lord just dropped on me was the church, the body of Christ. You know, just as Jesus was resurrected on the 3rd day, that his flesh might not see corruption. The Lord's just giving me more on that about preparing against the 3rd day, something that I've talked about before a couple of years ago. I don't want to hold that marker there for me. Anyway, so just as the Lord Jesus Christ was resurrected on the 3rd day, that his flesh might not see corruption, would not see abomination, would not see desolation, so the church, which is the body of Christ, on the 3rd day would be resurrected. The rapture, another name for the rapture is the resurrection of the saints. That's a resurrection. That's what he's talking about. People that die now are in heaven in their spirit man. They're not in a glorified body. No one is there in a glorified body but Jesus. But when the rapture happens, those who are dead in Christ, their spirits are in heaven. They'll come down and their bodies will come out of the ground first, as it says in 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 16, 17, 18, the dead in Christ shall rise first. They're already there with Christ now, but their body is in the ground here on earth. They will meet their body and they will have their glorified body, just like Jesus had a glorified body after his resurrection, where he could eat and yet he could walk through walls. People put their finger, you know, Thomas put his finger in his side and his hands. Jesus told him to, but yet the Lord could walk through walls and yet he could eat. That's a glorified body. And then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up with them to meet the Lord there. And then in 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 50, 51, 52, it says, "We shall not sleep, but be changed in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye." You know, we'll take off this corruptible body and put on incorruption. It's talking about the resurrection, the glorified body, the resurrected body. So we would not see corruption. So those who are truly in Christ will not see corruption. We will not see desolation. We will not see the tribulation. Brothers and sisters, this is the manna that the Lord gave me to share with you. And then I want to connect that back, as the Lord is telling me. When Moses went up on the mountain and he came back and he wanted all the people. This is the type of the rapture there. You know, Moses went up and God came down on top of the mountain. They met on the mountain. The Lord descended to the top of the mountain and Moses went up. And then all the people were supposed to follow. But they had to prepare for that. And, Moses told them to wash your clothes and all this stuff. Don't sleep with your wives. And then prepare against the third day to go up to meet the Lord on the mountain. So it was a type of the rapture, brothers and sisters. It's a common, theological thing that is a type of the rapture. But what's new is the other part. I told you I never heard anybody say, maybe they have, there was a fresh manna for me from the Lord and for this ministry from the Lord. And but in also says is reference to the third day. There's another time where there's in the Psalms where it says, I'll be dead and then I'll be resurrected on the third day, talking about Israel being resurrected on the third day. So with a day, as Peter says, 1,000 years is but a day to the Lord, and a day with the Lord is but as 1,000 years to us. You know, and it's also reference. I'm skipping all over the place. Follow me now. Adam lived 900 I believe it was 39 years. No man lived 1,000 years because God told Adam, in the day you eat the fruit, you'll surely die. And then, the devil's people, if you listen to, Satanists and wicked people on YouTube will say, the Bible's full of errors. That's an error according to the devil's people because they don't have an ear to hear. They don't have the Holy Spirit. And when God told Adam, the day you eat the fruit, you'll die, they said, well, Adam didn't die that day. Oh, but he did in a day to the Lord. And no man lived 1,000 years because 1,000 years with man is one day with the Lord. So also when it says, so follow me, when the Bible prophesies through the Psalms and says that, we'll be dead, it might not even be in the Psalms. In Old Testament, seems like it's in another book, so forgive me. It's a minor point. But it says in the Bible, in the Old Testament, this prophecy that, on the third day, it'll be 2 days, it'll be dead, and the third day be resurrected. That's connected to Israel. So for the last 2,000 years, to man's time, 2 days with God, Israel has been dead. Since the time that they rejected their Messiah, they were rejected, this wicked and perverse generation rejected the Messiah, seeking after a sign, but none was given save the sign of Jonah. That as Jonah was in the belly of the whale for 3 days and three nights, see, we're back to the three again, so shall the Son of Man be in the belly of the great fish, the whale, for 3 days and three nights. And so that's in our days. But it's the same thing. Here, so Israel will be resurrected. Now Israel is being resurrected right now. They're returning as a nation after 2,000 years. They restored their ancient language, as the Bible said, that the nation would be restored in a day and that their language would be restored. That's already happened. And now when the church leaves, brothers and sisters, the rapture of the true bride, those five wise virgins, Matthew chapter 25, then Israel will be revived and resurrected on that third day. And so some people say, oh yeah, they try to reject the rapture on the same point where they say, it's the day of the Lord. Well, the day of the Lord, brothers and sisters, are those of you who, if you're brothers and sisters, those who are debaters who say, the day of the Lord. Well, the day of the Lord is not one human earthly day. The day of the Lord includes the tribulation from the rapture and all the way through the millennial reign of Christ is the day of the Lord. When you look at the Bible and the references, the day of the Lord is that entire period. Right now we're in the church age. We're coming to the end of the second day with God. That 2,000 years, brothers and sisters, we're coming to the end of that. We are in the twilight of the second day of the cycle that God talks about. The third day begins at the end of the second day / the beginning of the third day is the tribulation period and the rapture. That's the transition from day two to day three. Then literally day three, the day of the Lord, is literally when he returns. The second coming of Christ and the millennial reign is the day of the Lord. It's not just, like I say, I'm repeating it again, it's not one earthly human day. Brothers and sisters, anyway, so God bless you guys. I wanted to give that out to you, and I, of course, I had to go through all that stuff for the benefit of the fact that YouTube is filled with people that are not preachers who make videos and releasing lots of just their, they read the Bible one time or they saw something on the internet, they copied and pasted it, and then they ran with it. And so by the grace of God, may people learn to rightly divide the word. Anyway, brothers and sisters, God bless you all. You know that I love you all. I'll see those people down in South Carolina starting tomorrow night, Sunday night. And then all of you guys I'll be seeing in Chicago. And I may even have to add more days in Chicago. It's such a great response. I may have to add some more days in Chicago. Please keep contacting me from Chicago. Let's set up some date. I might end up coming back to Chicago after I'm in Minneapolis, which will be through the 27th, I think it is, I said, of July. After the 27th. So I may have to come back to Chicago on July 28th, 29th, too. I'm praying about it. Please keep contacting me, RSVPing me, as they say, whatever. God bless you, brothers and sisters. I love you all in Christ. May you walk with the Lord daily. May He lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace. May His love shine upon you and fill your heart with His grace and love. God bless.